Welcome back to the Shtick with Dr. Grant Blashki right here in the studio.
Good to see you, Henry.
You
always
too,
good
Grant.
To be on your show. You're a national treasure, mate.
Welcome back. You were on the show many years ago in the hallway talking about the environment.
Yep.
And now tell the audience, what's your shtick these days?
Well, I work as a GP and I'm an academic at Melbourne Uni. But this year I've been working as the lead clinical advisor for Beyond Blue, which is a real privilege, and they're a great organisation to work for. So when I met up with you and you said, look, come and talk a little bit about what Beyond Blue's doing, I was delighted to come along, and always great to see you.
Where's it based? What's
the... Well, the actual office is in Hawthorne, but the organisation, it's a national organisation, raising awareness about depression, about anxiety, and also about suicide risk. So they've got a very broad goal. And I must say, working with them, it's been incredible to see how all the marketing people and communication people and clinicians work together.
And who's the current CEO now?
Well, at the moment, our CEO is Georgie Harman, and she's terrific. And our current chair is Julia Gillard. And it's a very professional organisation to work with. And I think most people, what I've found compared to other places I've worked, is that most people have got a soft spot for mental health. So if I'm doing any media work or speaking to people, they're always trying to help you because they've usually got a family member or a friend or themselves who's had some mental health issues. So it's actually been a real pleasure to work with them.
Yeah, because one of the things that I think that particularly Jewish people have in common is a sense of anxiety, this angst, which I think brings us into the sphere of comedy with people like Woody Allen, who is a real example of somebody who's, you know, tense and uptight. And it seems to be a trait in the Jewish community.
Well, we certainly, some would say, we have quite active minds as a group.
We worry, always worry. I'm worrying, I can't get this, you know. It's on my mind all the time.
Well, what's interesting, and I was surprised to say this, but in Australia, you know, for many years we've known about depression and probably 1 million Australians experience depression, but not many people realise that about 2 million people are experiencing anxiety issues. And so this has been a real focus for Beyond Blue on how can we raise awareness, how can we help people with these issues. So it's a real focus on anxiety at the moment.
Is there any particular drug that you prescribe for anxiety?
Well, I think very much the Beyond Blue approach to for people getting help is sort of a mixture of approaches. So first of all, if you've got anxiety issues, don't forget about the common sense things to do. Do some exercise, try and reduce your stress, maybe take up some meditation or some
take
mindfulness.
Take 10 deep breaths.
10 breaths, you know, like I said, we're nowhere near medications here. There's a whole lot of things you can do.
Without drugs.
Without drugs. And the other thing people should know is in Australia, you can go to a GP and the GP can do a thing called a GP mental health plan.
I heard about that.
Amazing, yeah. So what happens is the GP goes through your issues with you in a quite a structured way. You do a little quiz, and then you're entitled for up to 6 and up to 10 sessions, Medicare subsidised with the psychologist.
Wow.
Because the psychologists have got more skills and more time to help people with these sort of issues like anxiety issues. So people should know about that. If they're concerned and they're worried about the costs, then a good idea to get a GP mental health plan. Yeah.
And where do you divide the line between depression and anxiety?
It's such a good question. Look, I work as a GP, and you know things look neat in the textbooks and in the glossy brochures, but people are complicated, and they come in with a mixture of depression symptoms, anxiety symptoms, and here's something people might not realise: often physical symptoms. So many patients that we see in general practice, they'll come in
heart palpitations.
Bam. Yep.
What else?
Overbreathing, chest pains, headaches. Mm. And so we call this in GP land, we call it somatization. Mm. But a lot of cultures realise, obviously, that the way people express stress is not just through your mind, but through your body. And there's a lot of interest in the community in mind and body and how we work on those together. So I think the way that it appears for people varies. Another thing is that there's a different sort of patterns of anxiety that people come in with. Some people will get panic attacks.
Yeah.
Some people have more sort of social anxiety.
Yes.
And you'd be surprised. I mean, you and I will go out for coffee and think about it. That's a big deal for someone with social anxiety. They feel like everyone's looking at them. And then there's another group of people with what we call OCD.
Yes.
Obsessive compulsive disorder.
That's cleaning, it. Yeah. Cleaning, and making sure checking. They're dressed right. Worried about, what's OCD?
Obsessive compulsive disorder, yeah. Yes. So the thing about the anxiety issues is there's still a lot of stigma, and a lot of people say, well, you've got a bit of anxiety, you know, harden up. Don't worry about it. You'll be right. We're all stressed. But when you see in the clinic what people are going through, it really affects their lives, their work lives, their home lives, their relationships. So it's not a minor thing. It really, you know, I was at the clinic this morning, and of the, you know, 20 patients or so I saw, I reckon four people had sort of significant anxiety issues, quite common.
And what's PTSD? I think that's the next level down. I mean, when you're talking about anxiety and depression, you're working on a downward scale, aren't you, which is a lower end.
Well, there's been a lot of interest in post-traumatic stress disorder. As it's sort of classified by all the sort of clever researchers and things, they don't put it in the anxiety basket anymore. They say, look, it's its own condition.
Mm.
And, of course, it has some anxiety elements to it.
Oh,
but
yeah.
People with post-traumatic stress have a lot of issues. Last year we ran a conference in Israel.
Yes,
with Professor David Forbes.
Yes.
And we had people come from 16 countries, people from the local population, people from the Israeli army, Palestinians came along, all sorts of people came along. It was
really interesting. Yeah.
Talking about the effect of stress on their mental health.
Mm. And there are a whole form of raft of new, what do you call it, medications, but one of them is medical cannabis, which we won't go into now, but that was one of the, what's the word I'm looking for, cures for PTSD.
Well, it's really interesting. I think that Beyond Blue certainly had quite a conservative view on what treatments we recommend. But every few years, and we did one a couple of years ago, we do a review of the evidence. So on the Beyond Blue website, there's a really good document called Treatments That Work.
Yeah.
And there's one for anxiety and there's one for depression. And it says, hey, here's this treatment. And there's a million studies for it. We'll give that one 5 stars. Yeah. Here's this new treatment. Might be good. We're not sure yet. We'll give that one 1 star. So I think, you know, as a scientific sort of perspective, we try and rely on evidence. Mm. But, you know, as things progress, there's definitely new treatments that come along and that can help people.
Well, I really want to thank you, Grant, for coming into the studio. And next, coming up in the next segment is a fellow called Nigel Strauss, who's a clinical psychiatrist. And he's trying to introduce new laws into Australia to be able to give prescriptions for psychedelic drugs. How interesting. That's the next level.
Well, that will be very interesting. And I think it's great that you're profiling mental health issues on your show. And thanks very much for having me on.
We'll see you in the next segment with Nigel Strauss.